Here are my ATV conversions in a lineup. Starting out, I have a RZR XP model. I have a two-wheel drive Outlaw 2007. I have a kids sportsman model. And this one's not done yet, but it's gonna be done soon. Here's the motor, it's just a mini bike. This RZR has a 075-7R motor, which puts out about 70 horsepower. And it has quite a bit of torque, as you can imagine. I stuffed 31 kilowatt hours of battery in it, NMC cells. It's been performing very well. It's about or better than the 900cc motor that was in it originally. I currently have it geared down to a top speed of 40 miles per hour. And that's simply because of the constant power rating of the 7500 is having a hard time to push the 1600 pound 4x4 at a higher constant speed. So I gear it down for better climbing. This works great for plowing. The control at low speed is awesome. I mounted the motor up on top of the original transmission. I had this design built over 2 years ago, but then I recently found out about a year ago, Polaris did the exact same thing in their new Kinetic. They just used a 100 horsepower motor. I did not have access to a 100 horsepower motor. I wish I would have, but I was only able to snap up this used 70 horsepower. Mount the charger in the side-by-side. There's no technical reason why it's sitting out front there. It does not need to be exposed to the air while moving. Wall outlet plug adapter in here in this waterproof container up front, because typically I pull up nose in close to a outlet. This particular charger I picked because it's automatically switched between 110 or 220. I have two cords that I use. One is a 110 cord and it'll limit it to 15 amps. That way I can charge off of any 15 amp circuit, which is commonly found. If I plug it into 220, it'll bump it up to about 30 plus amps. The range in this particular setup here is about 110 miles of range, and that's of trail driving. It'd be a lot further if it was flat road, pavement, hard packed road. Let's talk about the interior and the inner workings of the electric side-by-side I built. The gearbox is still used. This retains the four-wheel drive, retains a low gear and high gear. Low gear is great for plowing, for pulling. Also, it gives me park, which locks the wheels. Otherwise, if I turn it off, it'll just roll away. If I didn't have park, I would have to have some kind of emergency brake. I also have a reset trip button set there. This switch right here is a forward, neutral, and reverse switch. The great thing about this is if I'm driving, I can go out while moving forward. I can just flip it right into reverse, keep the pedal on, and it'll just regen quicker down to a stop and then just start backing up. This is great for plowing. It's a nice smooth transition from forward to reverse. Makes for quicker plowing. Up here I have the same display that I also use in my sport quad. This is a CAN bus reader, a software that I developed. It also has ability to read information from the BMS. This button here, so I have it switch over to some information of the highest and lowest cell voltage and the amp hour rating and such. I have the headlights, the full drive is just the same as original. This is a controller I have for the hydraulic lift on the plow. And then got some high power lights up top and have some interior lights. Basically, this is set up one pedal driving. When I let out the pedal, just like the driving in my Tesla, it just regenerative brakes. And then the foot brake is used in extreme situations, I suppose. Definitely has more stopping power than it did originally. The acceleration is more than original. Top speed isn't quite there yet, but I did have it geared at a higher top speed of over 50 miles an hour, but it was just overheating. I suppose if I were to build this one again, I would consider using the Hyper 9. I think it would have a better fit for this situation. I've seen videos where people have made them with a Tesla motor. I think that's overkill. And plus, if you use a Tesla motor, you'd have to use the gearbox, which means then it'd be more complicated to retain the full drive. This kid's quad was my first build. This was the experiment to see if it could be done. I built this a few years ago, and I first started out with a small 3 kilowatt hour motor. At first, I tried it without a gearbox. Found out that the gearing is just too tall. Nope. Made a gearbox made up to it, and it worked out pretty good, but just a little bit lack of power that I would like. Now I upgraded it to a QS138 version 2, and the power is unbelievable. This thing will do wheelies, will carry adults. Let's take an overview of the setup. Drum brake in the back, and the original front drum brakes. Has a key switch I installed here on the side. And then the original display that comes with the controller and motor. I have it set up to also so that the gearing and the controller are set up to properly display the speed. On the right here, I can go ahead and take it out of park, and you'll see here it goes to a number 2. They call it a gear, but it's not, or a user setting of 1, 2, or 3. I have 1 set to the same speed as this quad was originally, which was a top speed of about 23 miles an hour and a really slow acceleration for a beginner. 2 I have is pretty much what we are using. It limits it to just under 40 miles an hour, which is still way too fast for this smaller frame. But I also limit the acceleration as well. Number 3 is just all out. It gives it all it can. And it's plenty fast. Plenty of acceleration, but I wouldn't use it. This does have you reverse here. We go ahead and hit the reverse button. You see the display will display here that it's ready for reverse. It's a twist type throttle, and that's just because on this particular throttle, that's what came with the kit. I go ahead and I can drive forward. This Outlaw was my third build. I built it because I had so much fun with the kids' quad, I wanted some for myself. I tend to trail ride. So these old Outlaws had a version that was an independent rear suspension, which is about as good as you can get for a trail ride. A straight axle, I figured, wouldn't have the clearance. It would have been too rough of a ride for the type of riding I am doing. This was a lot simpler build than my side-by-side because it's just a motor hooked up directly with a chain to the drive line in the rear. Battery pack here is over 11 kilowatt hours. Definitely take this thing more than 70 miles of range. The motor is capable of 70 horsepower, but I have it limited about 50. And that's simply because the weakest link in this design is the battery pack. Even though it is over 105 volts and can sustain 400 amps, the motor could take up to 800. It has plenty of performance. I'll put some of the specs down in the below. I have a custom display here that I set up to read CAN bus messages. It tells me the speed, the battery status. I have a button that I can change the display if I like to know more information about the battery.